You're welcome to Open Heaven's Devotional Commentary, a guide to a close fellowship with God. I'm Salami Nejo Haruna, your host. We are glad to have you. Hello, good day, and thank you for joining us today again. Open Heavens is written by our Father and the Lord, Pastor E.A. Adeboye, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. This commentary intends to bring insights to God's Word by the help of the Holy Spirit. Today's date is Friday, the 23rd day of February 2024, and our topic for today is A Call to Diligence. Please let us pray. Our dear Father, we worship and we bless your name, King of Glory. Thank you for your love, your kindness, your protection. Thank you for saving us from the wicked plans and plots of the enemy. Thank you also for saving us from the way of destruction and bringing us into your light. As we study your word today, Lord, we ask that you would breathe upon it. Minister to us with the wisdom from your word. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. Our memory verse for today is from the book of Proverbs chapter 12 verse 24. Proverbs chapter 12 verse 24 reads, "The hand of the diligent shall bear rule, the slothful shall be under tribute." Proverbs chapter 12 verse 24. Our text for today is from the book of Acts chapter 28. We'll be reading from verse 1 to verse 6. Acts chapter 28 from verse 1 to 6 reads, "And when they were escaped, then they knew that the island was called Melita. And the Barbados people showed us no little kindness, for they kindled a fire and received us everyone because of the present rain and because of the cold. And when Paul had gathered a bundle of sticks and laid them on the fire, there came a viper out of the heat and fastened on his hand. And when the barbarians saw the venomous beast hang on his hand, they said among themselves, 'No doubt this man is a murderer, whom, though he hath escaped the sea, yet vengeance suffereth not to live.' And he shook off the beast into the fire and felt no harm. Howbeit they looked when he should have swollen or fallen down dead suddenly. But after they had looked a great while and saw no harm come to him, they changed their minds and said that he was a god." Acts chapter 28 from verse 1 to 6. God bless the reading of his word to us today in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Our topic for today once more is A Call to Diligence. And in the body of our devotional for today, our Father and the Lord says to us that, "When I realized that if God hadn't found me, I would have remained as a university lecturer heading towards hell, I made up my mind not to be an ordinary Christian." A mathematician who doesn't want to be ordinary will study those who excelled and reached the top, like Pythagoras and other great mathematicians. "As I didn't want to be an ordinary Christian, I spent 3 years studying some people who God used mightily. One of such was Elijah. If you have listened to my series of sermons titled Going Higher, they can be found on Dove TV's YouTube channel, you will know that I have spent a lot of time studying Elijah. I also studied Paul because he was an academic, a professor of law that went into ministry like me and ended well. I found out that according to 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 6 to 8, he was a diligent man. Paul was diligent in every facet of his life. In Acts chapter 28 from verse 1 to 6, when there was a shipwreck on the island of Malta, while everyone was gathered around the fire because of the cold, it was Paul who went out to fetch firewood. In the earlier days, during the RCCG conventions, my boys and I used to fetch firewood for the conventions. We also washed plates and did other menial work with joy. Whenever it was time to wash plates and anyone wanted to collect the sponge from me, I would tell them, 'Wash your own portion of plates, let me wash mine.' The hands that cannot do manual labor for the kingdom cannot heal the sick. When a program is going on in your church, do not shy away from doing menial work. Get your hands dirty and you will be amazed how the anointing will begin to surge through your fingers. many of the assistant general overseers in RCCG now were my boys in those days. This is because it is those you knew to be diligent when you were starting out that you can trust to remain diligent when you are successful. I have seen people advise that there are lots of people with great callings these days. They may have a calling, but have they been tested? Your calling is never enough to succeed. Can we put you in charge of something and go to sleep knowing that you will do the work as it should be done? Only those who are diligent can make full proof of their calling. God bless His word to us today in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Our topic for today once more is a call to diligence. And we are reminded today of the irreplaceable importance of diligence. If we want to get to the top, then diligence is not an option or a choice. Our memory verse for today states clearly from Proverbs chapter 12 verse 24 that the hand of the diligent shall bear rule. The Amplified Version tells us that the hand of the diligent will rule. It says, but the negligent and lazy will be put to forced labor. In a world where the new generation is thinking that you can get rich quick and that you don't necessarily have to follow through process to get to the top, we must be very careful because even our God rewards diligence. He wants us to follow through process. He wants us to grow into what He wants us to be. And He wants us to enjoy the process every step of the way. To reach the top, we learn from our study today that one of the ways to do this easily is to learn from those who have gone ahead of us. We can learn from those who have excelled and reached the top. Study them, study their habits, discover the challenges they faced and how they were able to surmount them. That way you'd be better equipped to face life's journey. Another way to be diligent is to demonstrate humility in service. Sometimes those assignments, those tasks are only trainings, a grooming ground for where God is taking us to. But when we become too proud to engage in them, we miss out on the opportunities that could have also followed. In today's study, for example, our Father in the Lord tells us that the hands that cannot do manual labor for the kingdom cannot heal the sick. Discovering this secret is like discovering a gold mine. There are countless of testimonies from the lives of those who have submitted themselves to doing certain things that are considered menial in the house of God. Once upon a time, ahead of a one-time deputy governor of a state in Nigeria, who was a sanctuary keeper, what we know to be a member of the sanitation department, and this was while he was still in office. There is no doubt that he had seen the positive impact of that upon his life. You can imagine the deputy governor of a state gladly and joyfully scrubbing a restroom in God's house. He must have been doing this before he was anything. And even after God elevated him, he still held on to it. He never outgrew it. In our study for today, our Father and the Lord explains to us that having a calling is not enough to succeed. That God has called you is not enough guarantee that you would be successful at the call. You have to be diligent to that call. Come rain, come shine. You have to be dependable to the best of the ability that God has given to you. You must be diligent in the place of prayer, in the place of study of the scripture, in the place of constant and consistent learning. You must be diligent in the place of humility and service, in the place of honor for those who have gone ahead, instead of arrogance and pride. God does not want us to despise little beginnings. He wants us to embrace them and to be faithful even in little. That is how you can be entrusted with more. Today, no one wants to start small anymore. But the glorious future that God has in store for us may not look like it at the onset. But through faith and diligence, the picture would become perfect. I'd like us at this point to bow our heads and ask the Lord today for the grace for diligence. Ask Him, say, Father, please grant me the grace for unwavering diligence and dedication to every work you have assigned to me in the name of Jesus. Ask the Lord today that we would be sold out to every assignment He has placed in our hands, that we will not fail Him, ask the Lord today for the humility of heart to pass through every season of training that He may be taking us through. Ask the Lord to break us and to remold us into that perfect vessel for His use. Ask the Lord today for the grace to put every tool to work which He has given to us to make our assignment successful. Ask the Lord to take over our hands, our legs, our minds, everything about us, and let them be used for His glory in Jesus' name. Also ask the Lord today for the grace to learn from the examples of others, that where those who have gone before us have excelled, we would do even better and greater in the name of Jesus. Where they may have made mistakes or failed, we will not repeat the same in the name of Jesus. Now begin to bless the name of the Lord and appreciate Him for answers to prayers as you bring your prayers to a close. Father, we thank You. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Our gracious God, we thank You for Your word to us today. Thank You for reminding us of the need to be diligent. We ask that from this moment moving forward, we would demonstrate diligence in all that we do. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. We have a key point in today's study that tells us a calling without diligence will yield no success. We receive the grace today to add to our callings diligence in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. We have in our Bible in 1 year reading plan for today to read from the book of Deuteronomy chapter 5 down to chapter 8. We also want to sincerely thank you and appreciate you for joining us today. God bless you. If you'd love to speak to someone or to receive updates like this sent to you daily, please do well to send a WhatsApp or Telegram message to +234 80 986 11 226. Do well also to like, share, comment and subscribe to our various platforms available. Our hymn for today is the hymn 4 of our Open Heavens devotional. We would be singing, "To the Work, to the Work." We are servants of God. Have an amazing Friday ahead. See you tomorrow again by God's grace. God bless you and bye for now. I believe today's devotional blessed you. We are always glad to hear from you. So leave us a comment. Let us know how this has blessed you. Also remember to follow us on all our social media handles to get more like this. You can share this with someone to bless them too. We gladly look forward to seeing you tomorrow again. Have a fulfilling day ahead. God bless you.